So here I am at Hark to Kinch, and I've got my dowsing rods with me. So I thought I'd check and see if there's any energy here, any vortex, masculine and feminine ley lines. Look at the size of these stones. I'm going to walk around the circle in a clockwise direction and see if I pick up any energies. May it just have been the wind. I hope you can see the rods. No movement so far. No movement. I've gone around 180 degrees. Again, possibly just the wind. I'm detecting no ley line energies. Like our ancestors did 10,000 years ago, the spiritual leaders of our ancient cultures. They didn't necessarily place these circles where the energy was. They needed to activate the circle. For the last 7 years, I've been placing vortexes where masculine and feminine ley lines intersect at various places around the planet. I'm going to try and activate the vortex in the masculine and feminine ley lines right now. I call on the power of the spirits and angels of the seven directions, the east, the south, the west, the north, Mother Earth, Father Sky, and the God and Goddess within. I ask you to activate the vortex and the energies of this stone circle. Started in 2008, only 9 years ago, and during an economic crunch, the government stopped the funding to finish this circle. Right now, I feel that the circle is good enough to carry the energies, but I pray that the government funding is allowed so that they may finish the dream of the man that died in 2015. I wish you could feel what I feel right now. As we look around in 360 degrees, the sun visible during this time of the year all day from this spot. It goes around in a circle, 360 degrees. I'm now going to sense the masculine and feminine energies. And if they do intersect, that's where a portal or a vortex is created. To allow divine energy to come in and go out, to emanate across the planet, across a network of ley lines and intersections and portals. I'm going to start in the east. I hope you can see the rods in my hands. The left rod is starting to turn right now. That's the feminine. The left rod is the side of the heart. That's the feminine. Watch this right now. My hand is not moving. So the feminine line apparently is going to the Norwegian Sea. I'm going to continue around. This is the southern direction. The masculine rod just turned at the southern direction from south to north. Watch it. South to north. A vortex, a portal is created. This stone circle is now energetically activated. The same way our ancestors used to do it. The feminine line runs from west to east, We should see my left rod move as I walk past this gate, this opening. It's starting to move towards the east. It has, from west to east. As I approach the next gate, the right rod should go counterclockwise. Approaching the gate. The rod is starting to move now in direct alignment. Again, I'll just finish the circle. West to east, south to north. The feminine is west to east. The masculine is south to north. That's it. So if you've ever asked the question, how are our sacred sites located? In some cases, they would be located at natural electromagnetic lines called ley lines, where the masculine and feminine intersect, but they could also energize locations and create portals and bring in ley line energies where they prayed, where they willed. This I believe without a doubt, because you just saw it. We now have a brand new sacred site. Not ancient, but it does the same thing. And in July, apparently, they're going to start construction on it again.